Hello. So I got a couple of questions regarding the motion capture settings. So I'm going to show this how you set this up. So I have well, forget about this character. I was just messing around with it. Let me remove this. Doot, 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 doot. Boom. Let's take a look at. Let's load a different one. I'll come back to the characters in a minute. So, in terms of motion capture, let's take a look on the options that we have. So right now, I have my iPhone here. You see that it's already linked to this character. If I want to link it to this character, I can do that as well. I was just messing around with her, so let me just reload that. Not this one, and I'll take her. Let's say I want to have a different one. I'll take her. Okay, so now I have two characters here. I go to my MoCap. Let me move this. And right now I have nothing selected, as you can see. You see that every MoCap has multiple settings. So you have your microphone. This is if you don't have any external MoCap devices. It will literally just take the waveform and apply that to. I'm now using my microphone for my recording, but you could put your if you're not recording it, it will take the standard microphone input. Now, you can mix head, body, and hands, right? So what we're going to do, I have, for example, a iPhone. It's an older model, so my iPhone. So I'm using FaceCap, which is an OSC app. There's many other OSC apps. A lot of the motion capture companies are kind of providing that. And you can see that that works really nicely. The reason I'm using that is because the Lifelink, which is a free app, it overheats my phone. But that just works as well. It works as well, But if you have like an iPhone 10 or something like that, I would recommend using FaceCap. The big thing that you need to know is that I have my phone connected via a Ethernet cable. You can do that via Wi-Fi, that works, but you want to have minimum latency. So if you have a lightning to Ethernet cable, it's much better. As you can see now, both of these characters are responding to me, and they're doing a good job. If I want to be a little bit faster, what I can do, I can press my P. I can see my FPS. See, they're a little bit in red, so what I'm gonna do is set my settings to high, and I'm gonna set this to performance. So now my FPS is better, and you see that works quite nicely, especially given the fact that it's driving two characters. So that's the face. What I can do next is, actually, first of all, I'm gonna see if this is working on the YouTube because I don't see a window here. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba. I don't know why that's not there. Studio mode. Well, anyway, I'll quickly do this. So here you have multiple settings. I can intensify the you know, the quality. I can say, do I want this head rotation or not? You know, I can switch that on or off if I record that. I can also switch this off and go for body. So right now I have, let's take her. I have two different things selected. So I have a VMC protocol, which by default is going to this part. I can also use this, which this is just a camera, right? So this is just, as you can see, this is just a webcam. You know, in this case, like a $50 webcam. And it's doing a pretty good job for that. You know, it's obviously not like a motion capture suit, you know, but for what it is, it's doing a pretty good job for that. I can say, you know, if I want this character to sit, for example, let's only do the upper body. And then I can put a different animation on the lower body, putting that on the timeline. Let's say, for example, if I want to, let's say I want this character to sit, I can do this, add to track, and then I can do, drop this one on here, and just say, use the lower body only. Let me give her a chair here. So even though the character doesn't really, and then you could put this to loop, for example, right? So continuous loop, or you can bounce. Let's say we want to bounce. So now that should still give a little bit if there's some leg movement, but there isn't. But so now I have, you see, I have the character sitting. It's not looking at the lower leg. And I'm doing my fingers and everything. I can also do, there's a new hotkey for hiding the gizmos. So now I'm in here and you don't see anything. Let's say I was looping this, yeah. So, loop, yep. So this is now basically going to loop this section and bounce. So if you put other animations on there, that's fine. But as you can see, we don't have facial animation now. So let's go back to the mocap section. What I can do now is you can actually get facial tracking from the iPhone, from the webcam. It's not that good, so I'm not using that. You can have the head tracking and so on. But since I have an iPhone in front of me, I'm just gonna add the facial tracking from the iPhone. So now I have, I'll make it a bit more expressive. And hey, so now you can see, yeah, hello, how are you doing? Hey, yeah. So that works quite nicely for an old iPhone that you could probably pick up for $100 and a, you know, $50 webcam. So that's something I wanted to show. Now let's say we're not going to use the body. Let's say you don't want to use that. You can use this also for, you know, when you go to body, you have many other options. You know, all the suits are supported. Perception neuron works really, really nice, and have great support. But you can also use, for example, here, for the hands, I'm going to use, I have like a little, let me see where this is, if I can show that. This is also very cheap. It's like a little leap motion. So you can also use this. So I'll put it here. I'll say ultra leap. And you see where that leap is placed. I try to mimic that now, you know, so I can change that placement. And I want to put that in the same way as basically my my camera. Actually, I'm gonna put this on the top of my keyboard so you can see that now. I have a very stiff USB cable, so it's a little bit difficult to place. Come on. Okay. And so now you can see it also has finger motion. What I can do is basically kind of edit this placement. I'll take a look at my leap. Where's the edit to leap placement? And I can basically go and move this a little bit, as you can see. So I'm going to move this a little bit forward, because I want this to match with where it is. So in terms of being top on top of my keyboard, this is more or less where it is. You know, the better you place this, that kind of works. So as you can see now, you know, I'm sitting here. I still have my hands. You know, what's nice about the leap is that it works super quick. You see that? It's like boop, 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 you know, very, very, very quick. So this gives you also a pretty, you know, decent and cheap way to get motion. But obviously, you know, the better your gear, the better your performance. So that's just one thing I wanted to show. I'll switch this off now. Let me get rid of this. Then another thing that I kind of saw with a lot of people is that you can actually switch that leap off. Placement off. Switch this off. In terms of the characters, so I'm gonna put her here. We're gonna do a little bit of designing. So I see a lot of people just using the default assets. That's fine, but there is a whole configurator here, right? So if you want to load these, that's fine. But there is, if you go into your shapes and all that, there's a lot of things that you can do, right? So I can go and tweak her, make her a bit more alien, whatever you want, right? So there's a lot of options to configure that. So if I want to have a more anime face or whatever, there's a lot of things here. And what's really cool, this is my favorite, you can actually kind of over exaggerate these and do all sorts of weird kind of glitchy stuff, but that's a different story. Additionally, what works really well is you can basically take outfits from other characters, right? So if you want to make something unique, say like I have her selected, but I want to have the outfit from this girl. Oops, no, that wasn't what I was trying to do. Actually, maybe that's not fixed for the ladies yet. Let's try the man. That seems to have gone. There we go. So if I want to load other outfits, you can do that through here. I'm not sure if that was clear. You see, so I can keep that same character. Let's actually say we want to put this guy's body in here. I would select this. There's some issues sometimes. Still working on that, so bear with us. I need to look at this anyway. Never mind. But apart from this, you know, you can really tweak your outfits, right? So there's a lot of stuff here that you can do. There's a huge library of things. So yeah, I would really love it if people would test that and, you know, report as if there's any issues. Like things like this here, you might look at that and see, oh, this is a bug. But you can fix all these things, right? So if I would go to my lower body here, I can scale that up or pull it in, whatever I want. So there's a lot of control over what you can wear in terms of, you know, outfits, layering, and so on. Anyway, that's all I wanted to do today. So hopefully this worked, and see you next time.